ಓಪನ್ ಡೇ ಅಟ್ CFTRI. CFTRIಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಜನರಲ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅವರು ತಯಾರಿಸಿದಂತಹ ಹಲವಾರು ತಿಂಡಿ ತಿನಿಸುಗಳು ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ರು. ಬನ್ನಿ ನೋಡೋಣ ಅವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ.
ಇದೊಂದು ಸಿರಿಧಾನ್ಯ.
ಸಿರಿಧಾನ್ಯ
ಸೊ ಸಿರಿಧಾನ್ಯಗಳ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ತೆಗೆಯುವಂತ ಮಿಷಿನ್.
Gujarati dish,
okay.
Chapati making machine.
Oh.
Finished chapati making machine.
Okay.
It makes around 800 chapati per hour.
800 chapati per hour, okay.
It costs around 3.5 to 4 lakh.
Sorry?
3.5 to 4 lakh cost, its cost.
Oh.
Thank you.
ಇದೆ. ಇದು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಮಷಿನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ನೋಡಿ. ಇದು ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು, ಲಾಕ್ ಆಯ್ತು, ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಾರಿಜಾಂಟಲ್
ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ.
ಈಗ ಒಂದ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯಾವ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್
ಒಂದ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್
ನಲ್ಲಿ
ಎಂಟು ಭಾಗ, ಒಂದು ವಿದಿನ್ ಒಂದ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಟು ಭಾಗ. But major work is how to make consumable proteins, how to replace the non-vegetarian meat. We don't want to take meat, but we want to have more energy. What is the possible way? Possible way is we make a protein, you know, the seed that is groundnuts and also soya. These are the seeds which contains huge amount of protein. So we take up that protein, we isolate that protein, introduce it to any other food which doesn't have any protein in it. So this is how we build up the kilocalories. This is one area of our protein. The another area is everybody has around 5 kilograms of bacteria in our food. Okay? There is an imbalance sometimes. That imbalance leads to illness. Sometimes you have a throat infection,
you get into viral, many things.
That is a big imbalance between the harmful and useful bacteria. Okay? So it means that there is always a fight between the useful bacteria and pathogenic bacteria. So there is a way how it can control the pathogenic bacteria, isn't it? So we isolate these bacteria from human bacteria, the useful bacteria, and we find out there is a protein which can mimic antibiotics. Okay? So antibiotics, now people are not relying on antibiotics because most of the bacteria are antibiotic resistant. Okay? So after consumption of antibiotic also there is no meaning. So we developed isolated new antimicrobials which can be much superpower compared to antibiotic. And these are the from bacteria, human stomach only. So there is no question of regulation. And now we have different bacteria from gut which can kill different other pathogenic bacteria. So we have isolated different antimicrobials. One can kill listeria, the another can kill salmonella, the other the streptococcus. So all these antimicrobials, gene level, we take, we make fusions like chain. Okay? We engineer E. coli in such a way it will produce these antimicrobials. So it will become in future, maybe there will be antibiotics. So this is a marvelous work which is maybe in 2 to 3 years there won't be any antibiotics. Only these things will come to mind. And here we developed one antibiotic, antimicrobial, which Aditya Birla has taken. More market, if you go, vegetables are fresh always. It is mainly because we have given a technology where you can introduce a powder into water and then dip your vegetable. It will be shiny, fresh, no germs, no bacteria.
And no chemical?
Huh?
No chemical.
No chemicals. Chemical free. So these are the future technologies. And we are interested, we will be delivering soon.
Yes.
You can see some orange color band over here. This is DNA. This DNA we have extracted from bacteria. Okay, so how we after we extract the DNA, we use, because we cannot see the DNA with our naked eye. All of us have DNA. So we, since we cannot see it with our naked eyes, we add a dye to it. So that dye will go and bind to the DNA molecule, and it will become brighter, or it will become fluorescent. So once it becomes fluorescent, we can run it in a gel called agarose gel, and then we view it in this instrument, which has a UV light. So once this UV penetrates the DNA, it will this dye will become bright. So wherever this dye is binding to the DNA, that area will become bright like this. So we know that over here this DNA is there. So now we have isolated this DNA from a bacteria, and that DNA we have cloned, and we have made an enzyme like this one. So have you ever had flat beans at home? The green flat beans which we use. So from that, those flat beans we extract, like we call it guar phali or in Hindi or something, guar beans. So from that, from those gums we extract this gum, see how thick it is. So this thick gum is used in various food products like ice cream and other things. So after we have isolated this enzyme from this bacteria, we use this enzyme to make it less thick. So once we add this enzyme, it breaks the bond in the substrate. Then it becomes, once the bonds are broken, it becomes less. So this we use for prebiotics to add it to other food products like some bakery items, biscuits. Since this is very thick, we cannot add to bakery items. So we use this enzyme and we can add in bakery items. So we get to utilize the full product.
This is extracted DNA from banana. Just simply fresh banana in hot water, and then just add salt, little bit salt or SDS like soap oil normal, and then if we add little alcohol, this DNA we can see it will be floating in the surface. So the students can just see the DNA, the mass of DNA in the test tube or whatever.
Okay.
Peanut butter, soybean products, soybean protein concentrate, soya protein hydrolyzate. Full fat soya flour. The peanut butter.
Okay, peanut in the butter one.
Well, sesame products.
Mm-hmm.
Dehydrated sesame, heat resistance, sesame and all. It is sesame based nutrition enriched product.
Okay.
Into energy food.
Mm-hmm.
It is a very, very product. Nutritionally, it is rich in all essential amino acids. It is made from ingredients.
Basically protein rich food. Okay.
It contains a protein. It can
purify
water. Now in the Murga industries, after extracting the oil, they are finding that there is no value for that cake.
Okay.
They are using it for as many purposes.
Mm-hmm.
We have developed a technology to extract the protein which has got the flocculant property.
Mm-hmm.
Which can work exactly similar to
okay.
Chemical which we
have for purification water.
It's a natural product.
Okay. How is the cost difference?
0.5 gram is given for 100 liters.
Cool.
Thank you. ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಆಚೆ ಸಿಗೋ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೆ ಹಾಳಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಸಿ ಎಫ್ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಐ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 1 ಇಯರ್ ತಕ್ಕಡಿ ಇವಾಗ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಇದು ಪನೀರ್ ತಿಂತೀರಾ? ಪನೀರ್ ಇದು ಬಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಫಿಶ್ ಇಂದ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಸೀರಿಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಪನೀರ್ ಹಾಕಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಅದೇ ಥರ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನೀವು ಹಾಗೆ ತಿನ್ಕೋಬಹುದು, ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಸ್ನ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೊಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಕರೀಸಲ್ಲೂ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ತಿನ್ಬೋದು. ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ರಿಚ್ ಡಯಟ್, ಇವಾಗ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದ ಮಲ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ತಪಾಸು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಈಟ್ ಫುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳದ್ದು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ.
What is this?
Egg crunchy bread, sir, made up of egg.
So, thank you.
ಸರ್, ಇದು ಬಯೋರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇರೋದು ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಇರೋವಂಥ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ, ಫಂಗಸ್ನ ಕಲ್ಟಿವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತೊಗೊಂಡಿರೋ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್. ಈಸ್ಟನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬೇಕ್ರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತು ಕೇಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ಆವಾಗ ಈ ಡ್ರೈ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ನಮಗೆ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಈ ಥರ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಬಯೋರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಿರೋಂಥ ಈಗ ಗ್ರೋ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೇನು ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ ಬೇಕಿರುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟರು, ಸಾಲ್ಟ್, ಶುಗರ್, ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್, ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ.
ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆವಾಗ ಇದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೋ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದು ಗ್ರೋ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಇದು ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ತೆಗಿತೀವಿ. ತೆಗೆದು ಡ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇದರ ಡ್ರೈ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾನ್ಯೂಲ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಚಿಪ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ರಿಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದೇ ಥರ ಬೇರೆ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಬಯೋರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೂಡ 1000 liters, 500 liters
ಬಯೋರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇಂಕ್ರೀಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಬೈ 20%. ಗ್ರೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್, ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಯುವರ್ ಉಡದ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೈಸ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ನೀವೇನು ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಪೌಡರ್ ಹಾಕಿದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಬೈ 20%. ಸೊ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಡ್ಲೀಸ್. ಇಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಡ್ರೈ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ,
ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು.
ದೋಸೆ ಅದೇ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ನೀವು ಫ್ರೈಡೇ ಅವ್ರ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಹೋಟೆಲಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ.
ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ
ಈ ಕುಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ರಾತ್ರಿ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ತಲುಪಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದು ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್.
These are fruit wines and these are fruit vinegars, and this is the mother culture from which we isolate the bacteria to complete the process of fermentation for the production of wine.
Normal bacteria and fungi which use the natural colors, so that can be extracted and can be used for food colorants also. Here for the rice we have added the directly we have added the fungi which gives the color to the rice. So after this fermentation it can be dried and can be used as a red rice. It's normally used in China or Japan, but in India also it's available. Market it's available in the name of red rice, which has many beneficial health benefits in it, like
five days.
So it won't give any soreness test. It's a freely available technology in the website.
You can download and use it. Okay, you can make it at home itself.
Yeah. And this is a FOS. This produced from this fungi. Usually it's present in garlic, onion, chicory roots and all. It's useful for diabetic patients. It's a natural sweetener actually.
Okay.
So it, because it, how much ever you want to take it, it's like normal honey only. But it won't be digested by the human body. It gives only the sweet taste. So it won't any effect on the diabetes. But it can be used by the microorganisms present in the intestine, good bacteria which helps in our digestion.
Okay.
So it uses this as a food for it. It's like very good source of food for those microorganisms. So it will increase its number, so it helps in the proper digestion and any ulcer problems or any inflammation.
Is it available in the market?
Yeah, it's available, but it's too costly. microbial source also. Okay. But developing into market size means
probiotic lassi.
Sorry?
Probiotic lassi, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome.
ಯಾವುದೇ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪೌಡರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರೋದು
ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗಿರೋ
ಇಂಗ್ರೀಡಿಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್
ಸರ್ ಇದು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ತಾ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಚಕ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮುರುಕು ಎಲ್ಲ
ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಚೇಂಜ್
ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು
ಇದು ಸಾರಿ
ಕೋಕಮ್ ಜೆಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿ
mainly 6 months life will get it 6 to 8 months
oh.
And without any packaging special packaging not required
not required
you can store as such
okay.
This is actually now foods are vegetables and fresh vegetables it's not available in the market
correct
platform.
Correct
so but we are having the technology each one has a different shelf life
mm-hmm.
So now this one will stay for 2 weeks
2 weeks
yeah this is 28 days
mm-hmm.
And this is for 3 weeks, this is for 4 weeks.
Okay.
So this, if you cut starting the month, then immediately it started pounding.
Correct.
So we are giving some pre-treatment to prevent the pounding
mm-hmm.
And we are extending the shelf life. Because it is fresh one, na, it's a dried means you can,
correct.
Otherwise because we are taken from low temperature.
Thank you.
first we have to add, if you want to make a soup, first you have to pour the soup, whatever the quantity of water required, you have to add this one, then seal this one and press this button. Okay. System is there, you have to break the system. After you break it, mix well for 1 minute and then you will get hot food after 8 minutes.
Okay.
This is the mixed spoilage indicator. So it is a paper-based indicator and it's very economical, user-friendly. So by visual change, color change, you can see whether your milk is fresh or not. So here it is an external indicator, it's a time temperature indicator. It's not in contact with the milk. It is a purely external indicator. So the green color of the indicator shows that the milk is fresh. And this orange color of the indicator shows that the milk is about to spoil. You have to consume within 3 hours. But if it converts from green to red color, it shows that the milk is spoiled. So this is the technology.
We are making films out of cotton, like we are dissolving cotton in sodium hydroxide solution, and we are extracting cellulose from it.
Okay.
And then we are coagulating using acid, 5% acid. Then we are neutralizing it, and after that we are casting for 48 hours and Teflon will get film like this out of cotton.
Out of cotton, biodegradable.
Biodegradable.
ಚಪಾತಿ ಚಪಾತಿ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, 1 month ತನಕ ಶೆಲ್ಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಇದೆ, ಏನು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದೇ ತರ ಏನು ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಏನಾದ್ರು ಸಡನ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಡನ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೂಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಸೊ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋಜರ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ತುಂಬ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ತಾನೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಳಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಚರು ಅದ್ರದ್ದು ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಳಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ಹಂಗಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಇದು ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟೋಸ್, ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟೋಸ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವಾಟರ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದೇ ಥರ 6 ತಿಂಗಳ ತನಕ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಏನು ಸ್ಪಾಯ್ಲ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ರೆಫ್ರಿಜರೇಷನ್ ಏನು ಬೇಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಥರ ಮಷಿನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಈ ಮಿಷಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಪ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್ನ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಟೆಂಪರ್ 6 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಸಡನ್. ಇದನ್ನು ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಮಾಮೂಲಿ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಚಟ್ನಿ ಸಾಂಬಾರು ನಾನು ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀನಿ, 6 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ತನಕ ಇಟ್ಕೋಬೋದು. ಇವಾಗ ನೀವು ಲಾಂಗ್ ಜರ್ನಿ
ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ,
ರೆಡಿ ಟು ಕುಕ್ ರೈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ರೆಡಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಆಡ್, ಇದು ಪ್ರಿಸರ್ವೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಹೀಗೆ ನೀವು ಇಡ್ಬೋದು, 1 ಇಯರ್ ತನಕ ಇಡ್ಬೋದು, ಹಾಳಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ರೆಫ್ರಿಜರೇಷನ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. 50 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಈ ಪ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್, ಕುಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 300 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್. 1 ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್.
ಹುಣಸೆ ಹಣ್ಣಿನ ಪಲ್ಪ್ ಇಂದ ಮಾಡಿರುವ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿ,
because if you roast it, it becomes caffeine rich. It is CJ rich, which is useful as an anti-diabetic and
antioxidant.
Based on this, we have developed these products. This is cold coffee, but it is enriched with or fortified with probiotics, lactobacillus. It will help for intestine and digestion, plus the health benefits of this what we call as fat reduction.
Okay.
This is as an energy drink like Red Bull.
Okay, carbonated coffee.
Carbonated coffee. It is coffee with CJ and carbonation. Mm-hmm. This we are serving tomorrow for these people. This is non-carbonated for aged people, those who don't like carbonation. It is nutri coffee, rich in nutrients and health benefits. These blocks with all added sugars, instant coffee and chlorogenic acid. Just one cube you can dissolve in hot milk, hot water or even soda and you can drink. So it will take half minute to dissolve any hot milk, normal water or even soda. Half minute and you can have this coffee.
Natural.
ಅಡಿಕೆ ಎಣ್ಣೆನ ಪದೇ ಪದೇ ರಿಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅದು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಯಾಟಿ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಟಿ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್. ಅದರಿಂದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸೀಸು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ಬೋದು. ಈ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ಗಿರೋ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಕುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ನ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನು 0.1 ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ NMOH ಟೈಟರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಟೈಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಪಿಂಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪಿಂಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಇದರದ್ದು ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ. ಬೋತ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಎರಡರದ್ದು ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯಿಂದ ನಮ್ಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಆಯಿಲು ಎಷ್ಟು ಫ್ಯಾಟಿ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಮತ್ತು ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಯಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಫ್ಯಾಟಿ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದೇನೆಂದರೆ ಆಯಿಲ್ನ ಪದೇ ಪದೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋದನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಒಂದು. ಮತ್ತು ಆಯಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜು ಪ್ರಾಪರಾಗಿ ಏರ್ ಟೈಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡಬೇಕು.
ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಹಾಗೇನೆ
ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಯಿಲ್
ಓಕೆ
ಫ್ರಮ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪ್ರಿಲಿಮಿನರಿ ಅಸೆ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಅಸೆ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಿ ಕಲರ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೈಲೆಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಟು ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ಸರ್. If you take this chemical with like our natural interested compound, when you add in this solution, it will turn into yellow color. That means our sample, like whatever we will take like from natural source, our this fruit will be having antioxidant activities.
And
then biscuits made from ragi.
Mm-hmm.
So we had earlier this high protein biscuits like this.
Okay.
So now we have some ragi based is also there. And these are the protein rich rusk, mm-hmm. which is usually not having protein, much protein. It is only made with maida.
Correct.
And these are the muffins which are made with natural preservatives. Mm-hmm. So usually these kind of cakes or anything, they have synthetic preservatives.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. To replace synthetic preservatives, we have used some ingredients, natural ingredients,
mm-hmm.
which can work as a preservatives. And they have also shown the same shelf life as the synthetic preservatives.
So this is how we have developed the technology for the cakes. And this is like soup sticks, usually it is made from maida. And now this is made with high protein, high fiber kind of things. So this is a soup stick with better nutrition. Then we have millets, which is usually ground into flour. But now we have a technology to ground into semolina, that is like rave, like thick. And from there you can make different kind of products like halwa mix, upma mix, rava idli mix. All these kind of products can also be made from millet. So this is regular upma mix, what we get from wheat rava, suji. And this is an eggless cake mix. Okay, we can make it at home, eggless cake can be baked. And these are gluten-free products, you know, like these are maida based, but these are biscuits, cookies and cakes which don't have maida at all. They have some other ingredients which are, like people are allergic to gluten. So for them we are not supposed to give maida, they are not supposed to take maida. So they'll be using this kind of products which are gluten-free.
Okay.
So we have developed products for biscuits, cookies, cakes and all.
People who are allergic. Items.
Yes.
That is pasta generally made from maida.
Correct.
And we added natural color instead of artificial color.
Mm-hmm.
So by that its quality will get improved.
Okay.
Nutrition quality is also improved.
But basically it is made with maida itself.
Rava and maida.
Rava and maida.
You can made it of whole wheat also.
Okay.
Okay. But the thing is here with using natural
colors.
Vegetables colors like spinach, beetroot, carrot, cocoa and all. They have been done.
Okay. Thank you. Wagyu biscuits. Thank you.
We are trying to extract fixed oils from Indian spices.
Okay.
Fixed oils are ones you must have seen in market, essential oils.
Yes.
In these oils, these are not there. They are removing this flavor compounds from these oils.
Okay.
We are generally targeting it for medicinal purposes.
Okay. The flavor content is removed. Okay. Fixed oil.
Yeah.
Fixed oil means without flavor.
Without the flavor. Essential oil means with the flavor.
With the flavor. They use for medicinal purposes.
We are targeting it for medicinal purposes. Later we will see it as a nutraceutical or in some drug or not. But that is a very later stage. Initially we are targeting it for some.
This is an alternative source of the cod liver oil.
Cod liver oil is rich in omega-3 fatty acids. But many people will not like the fishy smell. And vegetarians will not
avoid it.
Yeah, this is extracted from the plant chia seeds. We have extracted the oil which is rich in omega-3 fatty acids. So,
Omega-3 fatty acids are very important for human health.
Okay.
Like it's important for brain development in infants. It's also very essential for hair, skin and good health of nails.
Okay.
So, but it's lacking in our normal diet, in our usual diet, and fish is the only source. But as she said, fish oil is not preferred by many people because we have many vegetarians in our country and also because of the odor. So this could be a replacement for it because it has been obtained from a plant source. And it's a vegetarian source.
Which plant is that?
Chia.
Indian plant?
Yes. It is not an Indian plant, it's a Mexican origin.
Okay.
But now it is seeds are available and it's becoming popular in India. It's called one of the superfoods.
Superfoods. Oh.
Yeah, because it's very rich in this omega-3 fatty acids.
Okay.
So now it's available but it's slightly expensive compared to the other oil seeds.
Mm-hmm.
Because of this healthy properties that it has.
These three oils, chia oil, flaxseed oil and fish oil, these are rich in omega-3 fatty acids. Okay, their essential fatty acids, because our body does not produce it. We have to consume it, so that we are, our nutritional balance is, you know, maintained. Other oils like sunflower oil, coconut oil, groundnut oil, they are all equally important. Nothing like only this you have to consume, that you don't have to consume. Which oil you use depends on it. If you're using sunflower oil, maybe you can then switch to some other oil.
Don't just stick to one particular oil, that is what we recommend, because all oils have different fatty acid profiles. What is present in sunflower oil, present in coconut oil. So the thing is, you have to keep switching the oils. Maybe if you are making some salad or something, then you can use olive oil, sesame oil, mustard oil, some other oil. Just keep all oils in your diet. Don't just stick to one particular oil. That's what's called.
Egg?
Egg is actually
meaning that people usually tend to throw the yellow part of the egg and only consume the white part, because yellow part is nothing but cholesterol.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is, cholesterol is good because it is a fat. I mean, in that all fat soluble vitamins are present. Hormones, the precursor for hormones also. So we should not throw the yellow part. We should consume both yellow and white part. White part is nothing but 10% protein and rest of it is gold.
ಡಿಆಕ್ಸಿರೈಬೋನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಕ್ಸಿಡ್ ಅಂತ ನಾ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್ ಇದು. ಸೊ ಇದು ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ? ಈಗ ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಫುಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಊಟ ತಗೋತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಅದು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್ ತುಂಬ ಇದೆ, ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಸಿನ್ ಇದೆ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪೆಪ್ಸಿನ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಟಿನ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್. ಅದು ನಮ್ಮ ಊಟ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ? ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನತ್ತೆ ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ವೇರಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎಮ್ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ. ಎಮ್ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸರ್ ಒಂದು ಪೋರ್ಷನ್. ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಇದೆ ಸರ್, ಡಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇದು ಎರಡು ಇದಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇದು ಒಂದು ಇದು ಒಂದು, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ತುಂಬ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಮ. ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಜೀನ್. ಜೀನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್ ನಾವು. ಈ ಜೀನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಪೋರ್ಷನು ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇದರಿಂದ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್, ಆಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ಸ್. ಈಗ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ನಮಗೆ ಕಣ್ಣಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಇದೆ, ಆ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎಂದ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಇದೆ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ. ನಾವು ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ. ನಮಗೆ ಇದೆ ಸಲೈವ ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್, ಅಮೈಲೇಸ್ ಅಂತ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ನೀವು ಕೇಳಿರ್ಬೋದು. And if could have heard that, or ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಾತ ಅಂತ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕೇಳಬಹುದಲ್ಲ ಸರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ.
ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಗೋಧಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹಸಿರು ಬೆಲೆ ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಬೆಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ, ಒಳಗ ಇದು ಹುಳ ಇರ್ತಲ್ವಾ, ಹುಳಗಳ ಕೀಟಗಳು ಒಳಗ ಬಂದು ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾಶ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಒಳಗ ಹೋಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆ ಫುಡ್ ಏನೋ ಸುತ್ತ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಏನು ಫೀವರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿಸೆಂಟ್ರಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ಸರಿ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ದೆ ಅಂತ, ಒಂದು 1,000 ಟನ್ನು, 5,000 ಟನ್ನು, 10,000 ಟನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಪಾಸ್ಪಿನ್ ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಒಳಗಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪಾಸ್ಪಿನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆ ಗ್ಯಾಸು ಈ ಒಳಗಳು, ಕೀಟಗಳು, ಮೊಟ್ಟೆಗಳು, ಚಿಕ್ಕಗಳು, ದೊಡ್ಡದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೈಜ್ ಗಿಡಗಳು ಸತ್ತು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಾಶ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಫುಡ್ಡು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದೇ ಸೇಮ್ ಮೆಥಡು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರ, ಒಬ್ಬರು 5 ಕೆಜಿ 2 ಕೆಜಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸರಿ ಬರಲ್ಲ.
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು
ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುವಂತದ್ದು
ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್
ತೆಗಿತಾ, ಅದು ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ಜಸ್ಟ್
ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ,
ಇನ್ನ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ,
ಅದೇನಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೀ, ಯು ಸಾ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೈನ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫಾಸ್ಫೇಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್. ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾಸ್ಫೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಸಿನೋಜನ್, ಇಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ದ ಸೇಫೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಬಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಐಸೋಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಬಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್
ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. No.
You can't say anything, no?
No.
This one?
No.
No. So these are the ones which are treated with the biopesticide.
Okay.
But this is not treated, so you can see the insects.
Right? Absolutely not harmful. Okay.
Because they are all plant-based, which we use for our daily cooking purpose.
Okay.
And similarly, here this is wheat, you can see wheat
insects.
Yes. Insects in the wheat.
Mm.
And again, this is you can see very clearly in the green. See, you can you see the sachet here?
Yes.
And here also?
Yes.
So these are the things which contain these bioactives. And so we keep them here in this. This is a 5 to 10 kg level. So infestation will never come.
Here there is a food labeling information.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever the material, whatever the food is available in market regarding our human beings, so you have to test the sample directly. Mm-hmm. Blindly can't eat. For example, recently mag issue happened.
Mm-hmm.
So there after eating so many things happened that toxic levels is more.
Mm-hmm.
So regarding that one, you have to test the sample. Who will test the sample means FSSA. That is means here is there, madam, you can check. FSSA means Food Safety Standard Authority of India is abbreviation.
Mm-hmm.
So they will test the sample, they will send the information to the whoever manufactured.
Mm-hmm.
So the certificate and license number they will send to the company. That company people, whoever is going to the market, they are selling their samples in the marketing. So they will paste that information on the sample.
Okay.
So this is the atta powder, this is the, for example, take the atta powder, sugar sample, oil, you have to replace, depends upon their requirements, mm-hmm. their parameters, whatever, they finish the parameters before selling it to the market.
Okay.
Along with that, FSSA logo
mm-hmm.
and license number.
Okay.
Yeah, we can check.
For individual product, there will be a license.
Yes, individual product. You can take the ice creams, mm-hmm. you can check the chocolates.
Each flavor, there is a license.
License number is different.
Okay, okay.
If you have same logo.
Mm-hmm.
Logo okay. should be same,
same
but
okay.
license number is
different. Okay.
Important thing.
Okay.
If you want to check.
Can we verify that?
Like we can verify.
Okay.
So that is a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
You can go through the website www.fssa.gov.in.
Okay.
You can go there. We can enter that license number there, one option is there.
Mm-hmm.
We can check the license number. We can visible directly, it will open. If it is generic, it will open the company name and everything.
Okay.
Where the manufactured company.
Mm-hmm.
If it is fake,
it will open. Okay.
Now, whatever you provide that license number is not correct.
So, can we
complain?
After checking if it is fake, can we complain in that website or?
Food inspector.
Food inspector, local food inspector.
Local food inspector.
Okay.
So they will send the sample regularly.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They have to go there. For example, that is depends upon batch only. That batch only.
Okay.
For example, batch size is different. We don't know actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that food inspector duties, you have to go there. You have to check the sample. What is the packing? If it is the leaked anywhere, like this. They pack.
Okay.
How they pack? You have to check there. You have to send the sample to the FSSA.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the Food Safety Analytical Quality Control Laboratory. That is our nodal laboratory.
Mm-hmm.
The sample from their board,
mm-hmm.
we are receiving the so many samples regularly.
Mm-hmm.
We are testing the sample. We are sending the result to the company.
Okay.
Based upon their result, they will go for the court. They will ban the companies also as per the rules and regulations.
Oh.
So here is the offense and penalties.
Okay.
So these are the things.
Mm-hmm.
If it is substandard food, misbranded, so these are the fines.
Okay.
Because of that food causing death, so it will go this, not
imprisonment
also.
Okay.
You can do anything. For example, court, there will be any punishment.
Mm-hmm.
So, coming to this point, here is the scene. So, he is the one model.
Mm-hmm.
So, you have to clean the plates and everything properly. After washing the plates, you have to cover the soap with lid.
With lid.
Lid.
Oh, okay.
Any plate. And also wash with clean water.
Mm-hmm.
And also don't line the plates on the sink morning to evening. You have to clean properly.
Mm-hmm.
Regular intervals.
Mm-hmm.
That is the one option. Here they are, see how they are using the much water. And also after washing, they are not closing this.
Closing.
And also this is the microbial affected area, everything.
Mm-hmm.
So from this only, the microbial effect into the plate, from the plate only, it will go to the body.
Okay.
So you have to maintain hygienic condition. So this is the first thing.
Okay. Thank you.
Of oils,
okay.
Right? You'll extract some flax seeds, essence, all that. This is the oil. So this is like they will extract by cold press method or some instrument and solvents they will use to extract. Usually this oil will get 9 kilocalorie of energy.
Mm.
Okay, carbohydrates and proteins it's like 4 kilocalorie will get. So how to? I mean, sometimes they will adulterate mineral oil. Have you heard that mineral oil? Right? That is like petroleum products.
Mm-hmm.
That it is colorless and
odorless.
odorless. Yeah, they will have some color and they will mix with costlier oil. It's not possible to identify which oil is adulterated by visual, right? How to identify if they added any color like that? Just take some oil and add little hydrochloric acid. Or is some carriage acid, some that acids. If it is added with any other color that is like acid soluble colors, then it immediately that color it leaches out and changes the color. So if it is changes any other color other than oil color, then it is adulterated with some dyes. Then sometimes like cotton seed, they are extracting from cotton seeds. This oil contains gossypol that is causing infertility. Okay. This is not possible to differentiate cotton seed and sunflower. Mm-hmm. Is it possible to differentiate both? Mm-hmm. So how to identify? We just take oil and add Alphen's reagent. Then if it is stirred and you have to boil for 20 minutes after shaking, boil for 20 minutes. If it is turned to red or any red shade, then it is positive for cotton seed oil. Nowadays adulteration is more in ghee, that is dalda and vanaspati. So most of them, they thought both are same. No, this is what is dalda. It is like hydrogenated fat. They will mix 3 to 4 cheap oils to make that fat. Okay, that is during that hydrogenation process, trans fat content is more. That is not digestible in our body. If fat is not digesting, what it will happen? It goes on depositing. Then obesity problems like heart attack, some other problems. How to identify means just take some ghee and add hydrochloric acid and then shake it and add 2% furfural reagent. Okay. After adding, if you are getting like pink or red shade, then it is positive for dalda. Then I said mineral oil test that we can identify by using TLC, thin layer chromatography. That is aluminium sheet is coated with silica gel. Okay, it's just called your sample. This is the sample spot. Then run in non-polar solvent. What mineral oil is non-polar? So well, till the run you will get the white spot. Because non-polar it is mutually visible. Then okay. It will give that point. If the sample contains mineral oil, that same spot you will get. Then you can match the RF. Then you can tell it is positive.
Thank you.
ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾರ ಇಲ್ವೋ ಅಂತ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ಸೊ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ 3/4 ಅಥವಾ ಹಾಫ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಥವಾ ಕಾಲ್ ಭಾಗದಷ್ಟು. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಡಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ನೀರ್ ಇದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡ್ರಿಪ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮೇಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅದು ನೀರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಥವಾ ಅರ್ಧದಷ್ಟು ಇದೆಯಾ ಆ ಒಂದು ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬಾರ್ದು ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಸಕ್ಕರೆಯನ್ನ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೋಮೀಟರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಆ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಶುಗರ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೆಲ್ವಿನೋಕ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಾಜೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಾಕಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬಾಯ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಡಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಒಂದ್ 3 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ತರ ಟರ್ನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಶುಗರ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ್ದೇ ಕಲರ್ ಕೂಡ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅದಲ್ದೇನೆ ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹಾಲಿನ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಪೌಡರ್ನ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಮನೇಲಿ ನಾವು ಟಿಂಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಗಾಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದ್ 2 ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಈ ತರ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಲಲ್ಲಿ ನೊರೆ ಬರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಈ ಸೋಪ್ ಪೌಡರ್, ಶಾಂಪು ಈ ಥರದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬ್ರೋಮೋಕ್ರೆಸೋಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಲ್ ಅಂತ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ರಿಯಾಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಈ ಥರ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಪರ್ಪಲ್ ಬಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಟರ್ಜೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂರಿಯಾ, ಯೂರಿಯಾ ಏನು ಕಂಡು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ವೈಟ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಲು ಬೆಳ್ಳಗೆ ಬರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಡೈಮಿಥೈಲ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಬೆಂಜೋಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಈ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ಥರ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ಕಲರ್ ಬಂದರೆ ಯೂರಿಯಾ ಹಾಕಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಹಾಲು ಕೆಟ್ಟೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, ಕರ್ಡಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಲು ಕೆಟ್ಟೋಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು, ತುಂಬ ಹೊತ್ತು ಇರಲಿ, ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಆಗಿರಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಸೋಡಾ ಅಥವಾ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಬೈಕಾರ್ಬೊನೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ರೋಸಾಲಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್, ಇದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ಥರ ರೋಸ್ ಪಿಂಕ್ ಬಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೋಡಾ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಇದೀವಿ.